This is a moment of housekeeping, commissioners. Have you looked at the minutes from last month? And if you have, I would like a motion to approve.
Motion to approve the meetings, the minutes as presented.
Commissioner Hall has made a motion to approve. Do I have a second? Commissioner McClellan, a second. Minutes approved. We'll go ahead and start with our first case tonight. First case is a City of Valdosta case, CU-2014-09. Matt, would you present, please?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a conditional use request by Macedonia First Baptist Church. Jason is getting the PowerPoint slides up on the screen for you. But in your packet, there's a series of maps and some other information. This is property located on JLM Max Drive at 715. This is down the street on the south side to the east of West Street. It's an existing church that has been there for about as long as Valdosta has been around. That church dates back to 1865. My understanding, the present building dates back to 1913. And it is, after many, many decades, we're finally doing an expansion since the adoption of zoning that actually triggers some zoning compliance issues. They're proposing a new building that is in the form of a temporary classroom building that they were being gifted from the local school system to locate in the rear yard of their property. In the packet, there is a site plan that shows the existing church, also the building to the rear. This is zoned R6, single family residential district. It does allow churches with a conditional use, and therefore, since this is does not currently have a conditional use, and they're wanting to expand, it triggers this public hearing process. It's in the local historic district, and it has already been reviewed by the local historic preservation commission in terms of the building and its compatibility, and that has been approved a couple months ago. And the details of that approval are there in your packet. Being that this is a very integral part of the neighborhood, churches, particularly ones of this size and certainly of historic significance, are very much encouraged to remain and being encouraged to foster within the neighborhood. All that really boils down is that of the building itself. And since it's in the historic district, staff is wanting to maintain consistency in the Historic Preservation Commission conditions of approval. So therefore, the conditions of approval for the conditional use, as recommended by staff, are as follows. Number one, conditional use approval shall be granted for the existing church building and proposed temporary classroom building as approved and conditioned by the HPC. Number two, the church property shall remain unpaved until such time as future permanent buildings and future permanent site improvements can be properly master planned and approved by HPC. Any future permanent buildings that cumulatively exceed 1,000 square feet shall trigger full review of a submitted site plan with the park material and design approved by the engineer. These are things that we talked about at length at the work session. The idea being to let them go on as they have been for many decades, and once they get around to actually putting permanent improvements on the site, then that gets reviewed by the HPC and, if necessary, by us as well. Any questions?
If not, there's no questions from the commissioners. We will open the floor. For anybody that would like to speak for this proposal, please come forward and state your name and your address, please.
Thank you, sir. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is James Up, Council, June 2014, Baptist Place. And I'm here on behalf of Macedonia First Baptist Church. And I've been with this process since we started months and months ago. Of course, we tried to work out and come to an agreement to have it where we could have these classrooms and modular there behind the church. That was not our preference, but you have to give some, you know, you take some. So that's what we've been doing. Number one, under the conditional use, that I have no problem with that whatsoever. Number two caused me some concern. It causes me concern because what it says is that this property shall remain unpaved. I just read it this morning, got it off the shelf Friday, I believe, off out of town. But anyway, it shall remain unpaved until such time as a permanent build. What happens if there's never finance to do a permanent build? Does that mean you can never pave the parking lot? That doesn't quite sit well. With the church and our congregation.
just don't see the need for that particular part. And the purpose says, and future permanent site improvements can be properly master planned and approved by HPC. So, I mean, who is to say that there will ever be those things that you're saying here? So for that reason, second reason, that it should not be a part of this process. And whatever regulation requirements that we have to undergo at such times, whenever there is a request to pay, of course, we're willing to do that. But don't put something here that will cause problems because we may never have the funding. One reason we have it done like one of the local churches, that is, get somebody to build a whole new area for various uses because the size of the congregation and the limitations on financial. And that's basically accept this gift. And you know, so what I'm asking to do is just to leave number two off. I think it will not hinder the planning commission, will not cause any problems for anyone. But to put it on there is just like putting a yoke around your neck and saying that this is the way you got to do this. You got to build a building, and that's not in the future. And I'll be willing to answer any questions that you all may have.
I want to ask you about item number two. Are you concerned because you don't think that you can pave the parking lot if you don't build a building?
Well, what it says, I'm concerned about the language that's on here. What my concern is, it says the property shall remain unpaved until such time as future permanent buildings and future permanent site improvements can be properly master planned and approved by HPC. That's what the language is. I'm concerned about the language, that's all.
One question. Mr. Campbell, I understand your concern is the first sentence. The second sentence seems to me to be just a general statement that any future development will necessitate plan review and submittal.
Well, let's put that in there. That's what
you say.
I have no problem with that.
Well, respectfully, doesn't it already say that?
No, sir. Not what it says. Not just complaining about reading about this. Not that. I disagree with you. Someone else may disagree with you.
Right. Mr. Chairman, I think in the first sentence, a couple of the words could be changed to add a little more flexibility. I mean, that was staff's purpose. Condition number two was to grant this church the flexibility to add a little bit more than what they're currently asking for without having to trigger re-review of conditional use. Normally, any type of building expansion is going to trigger parking, paid parking. So we're trying to give them that flexibility as well. I think with the first sentence, it could read, the church property shall remain unpaved until such time as future permanent buildings or future permanent site improvements can be properly approved by HPC. Any permanent site improvements on that property are going to have to be reviewed by HPC. This just allows them to not have to pay until they get around to the permanent structures. But if they want to go ahead and pave in the meantime, they can.
So the only verbiage you've changed was just the four.
We could change the fourth word, shall remain, to may remain. That would clarify that. I mean, if they want to go ahead and pay ahead of time before they get around to the rest of it, that would be fine. And then at the end of that line, as future permanent buildings or future permanent site improvements. In other words, to separate the buildings from the site improvements. Will that help?
Yes.
Okay. I think that will help clarify a lot of those things I had not thought of before. As far as the second sentence goes, any future expansions are going to trigger full plan review. We're trying to put parameters on the use that's being approved, which is what this request is for, is conditional use approval, and to allow up to 1,000 square feet of additional permanent space to not trigger any re-review under conditional use, but beyond that would. And of course, beyond that, and even before then, it's going to cause review by the HPC. And we just simply put that language in there as a clarity.
So number two would be?
I think two is fine the way it is. Any future permanent buildings that cumulatively exceed 1,000 square feet shall trigger full review of a submitted site plan with park and care on design approved by the city engineer. What that, I think, infers is future permanent buildings that are less than 1,000 square feet do not trigger this. Well, I'm looking at the two sentences, but I think they go together.
So the whole thing would be?
Church property may remain unpaved until such time as future permanent buildings or future permanent site improvements can be properly master planned and approved by HPC.
Okay.
So that gives you the option to pave or not pave.
Yeah.
Okay. And then the other is the trigger is it doesn't occur until 1,000 square feet cumulative, additional. And that's an addition beyond the building that's currently proposed.
So really what this is doing is giving more flexibility in that space.
I appreciate all the help in the work. You. But you know what happens is when you have things loose in there, somebody else will be, they come up with a whole different conclusion.
Thank you, sir.
Any other questions?
Is anyone here like to speak in opposition to this request? If there's no opposition at this time, we'll ask the commissioners for a recommendation.
This was from the
I'd like to make a motion that we recommend approval of this conditional use request for the church. With the conditions that staff discussed, with the modifications to the conditions discussed and agreed by Mr. Kelly.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Next item on the agenda this evening.